So I have to find space in my home. My living room is pretty much my sanctuary. When it's especially holiday time, all the rooms are occupied. At the time, my bathroom was my closet. When she was talking, I received the anointing of the word of God in my bathroom. So your closet is the place where you
say, okay, you set up for God.
Daddy, let's meet here. Mm-hmm. And you make it consistent and you make it sound and valuable. Mm-hmm. No distractions.
Yeah. Mine will be the hall of the room between when everybody is inside. I will be in the hall.
Yeah.
Yeah, your husband.
You just tell your husband, like, leave me alone.
When he's sleeping,
he already know.
Your husband is a person, he sleeps.
Invite him to your prayer. He will leave you alone. He will leave you and say, no, thank you.
I'm even pity my husband because the time I'm always sometimes like, can you sleep a little?
It's all the way to the because end. Because if I say let's pray on the phone, you make time to pray on the phone. But I say no.
That's interesting. That is so interesting.
I say no. He said 101. I want to meet with everyone. I will do that on the
WhatsApp
group too. 101. He said, I want each one to get intimate with me. Then you will see the transformation. Because I know programs, they work for some people, they don't work for everybody.
Yeah.
And that's what a lot of the body of Christ like nowadays. We don't spend as much. We wonder, it's like God is not talking. God is talking, but we are not.
We are not listening. We are busy with religious stuff. Yes. Let's go here, let's do that, and let them know.
Oh, it's Christmas, let's do
people, like, silent night. Even if you go to any churches, you take a census and ask many people how many time a day they spend. Most people don't spend time.
Mm-hmm.
Like our time will be like you get up in the morning, oh thank you Jesus, thank you for the blessing day. We are gone. Oh, that's what
crazy.
Most people do.
He says, I never knew you.
That's why it's called the sacrifice.
Yeah. And you will see a lot of deliverance will happen to you just by being that person. Most of the things I was dealing with is only when I was one-on-one with the Holy Spirit. God, he knocked them out. When I get deep in the spirit, he said, no. Anger, out. I was very impatient. I have anger. Terrible. I will arrest myself.
But
He will tell me I have to fix what is inside your heart. You are worse than Moses. I say, okay. He told me that clear. He said, I need to fix or you will kill someone one day. I say, okay, daddy. He remove it. You understand? You come out of that change. But you can come to deliverance every time, nothing happened. Until you meet him and he says, okay, let me take care of it for you. Amen? And it's what he wants to do. He wants to transform life. Amen? Let's stand up. Amen?